On today's trip around the world, we are in Charleston, South Carolina. We looked into taking a food tour, but they were super expensive. So we researched the best places to eat around town, and we planned one of our very own. While in the Army for 35 years, Eddie traveled the world meeting so many interesting people and experiencing different cultures, but only where the military told him to go. Fortunately, during our 25 years of marriage, a few of his assignments provided us the opportunity to travel to some pretty amazing places too. So come join us on this adventure of a lifetime as the LaRosas jump around the world. So we just finished our walking tour of Charleston, and now we've worked up an appetite, so we're gonna head on into Prudence Court. We have our two samplers that we're going to try here at Pugin's Porch. So I ordered the she crab soup, and we're going to try it. So it's nice and creamy. It's really rich. And it has a little bit of a kick. A little bit of a kick at the end. So apparently, the she crab is just a female crab. I had to Google it because I wasn't sure, but it's really good.
Okay, this is fried green tomatoes, and this is pimento cheese and bacon jam.
Yeah.
And it's really good. The sauce actually takes over any flavor that this has, but it's well worth it. It's really good.
Really good?
Really good.
I've been researching, and one of the great places in Charleston is called Callie's Hot Little Biscuits. Super moist.
That's really good.
This one is cheese and chive, and they're little mini biscuits, so you can get as many as you want. I think there's even butter on it. Ooh, there's butter, or maybe that's cheese. Look at that. I think it's cheese. Okay. It's good because it has the chunks of cheese in it.
They're so moist, that's the best part.
Last one is blackberry. So it looks like it has a little bit of sugar on top. Obviously you can see the jam in the middle. I was thinking about getting butter and stuff with it, but you really don't even need the butter. Very good.
Right. Since Traci got the three little biscuits, I decided to get the bigger one with meat. I gave her the option of whether we would have goat cheese or one with sausage. So she decided we're going to go with meat. On here, we have an egg, pretty thick. Hopefully it's real. The sausage, and there's actually grits.
On the bottom. Yum.
So we had grits yesterday, and they're pretty darn good.
For the first time ever.
I had them in the military, but...
No, I think that's pimento cheese on the bottom.
Oh, really?
Remember?
Yes, I don't even know what that is, but anyway, here we go. Oh, good.
Really? I need a bite.
That's really good.
Really? What's good about it? All of it.
The cheese.
It's pimento cheese. I do remember her saying that. Yum.
Okay.
All right. Callie's hot little biscuit. Our phones are going to die. We have to go charge. But first, we're going to get ice cream at this place that I found called Track. Off the track ice cream? Track ice cream. But they have vegan ice cream. So we're going to go get some yummy flavors, hop into the car, and charge up a little bit before we continue on through Charleston.
You want me to say something? I come up with nothing. Maybe we can talk until we figure.
I got brown sugar, oat milk, and cookies. And there's actually chunks of the vegan oat milk in here. So.
See? Dairy is better.
No,
I was going to say it's all in your mind.
Whatever.
No, I was going to say it's so good. It's very creamy, and it's really good, and it's just all in your mind. Our daughter's vegan, so that's why we had to try the vegan.
All right, continuing with our Southern cravings. It's about dinner time, so we're going to try some maybe ribs. But we're here at Rodney Scott's barbecue. So let's give it a try.
Everything I've read says you got to go have barbecue here, so we're going to go on in and have it.
We got their signature pulled pork. We have collard greens, which I've never had before, I don't think. It looks like seaweed. And we have flesh puppies, which I think I have had before. So, without putting any sauce on it.
Okay.
Which over here?
There's lots of options. We got Kathy's, Other, and Rodney's. Okay, what about collard greens?
And collard greens. Kind of a spinachy kind of taste to it. Hush puppies. I didn't know what hush puppies were. I think you put this cream on it.
Like bread or something?
I like the butter.
I am gonna try the Kathy's sweet barbecue. It definitely needs flavor. Sweet barbecue. Definitely sweet and tangy. Got some pepper in there. Now we're trying the other sauce. Super tangy.
So we should probably stick with that one.
Well, I think I prefer the sweet.
Yeah, but you kind of have to go with the authentic barbecue.
I know.
I will.
Okay.
This is Rodney sauce, so I'm assuming it's their signature sauce. I put a little bit on my finger. It tastes really vinegary. So, let's see what it tastes like. So very watery. That's why I'm thinking it's a lot of vinegar. Lemon. I think I thought lemon concentrate on it.
So which one do you like better?
I don't know. I kind of like the vinegar.
That one? This one?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
All right. We've been eating all day. So now we decided we needed to top that off with some drinks. So we are at Firefly Distillery. And we're going to go in here and have a flight of all kinds of stuff. They have whiskey, gin, vodka, rum. So we're going to try it all. My tastings are apple pie moonshine, chocolate pecan moonshine, sweet tea vodka, and a whiskey jam blackberry. And I actually wanted his lemon, so I'm going to try his lemon too. Okay, this is whiskey jam blackberry. Smells really good. It is really good, actually. Sweet tea vodka.
Exactly.
This is Southern lemonade vodka. A little tart.
Is
it's
it?
Good though.
So it's a new day and we're continuing with our food excursion. And today we are going to
Miller's.
Miller's all day. They serve breakfast all day until they close at 3 p.m. So we're waiting for our table and then we're going to go see what they have to offer.
You want me to say something? I come up with nothing. Maybe we can talk.
So I got the hot honey donut. It is a cinnamon sugar donut with fried chicken, hot honey sauce, peach preserves, and there's some pickles under here. She said it's spicy, so check it out. Oh my god, what a mess.
It's good. It's good. There's a lot going on because of the spice and the peach. Like, I take Mr. Bite of Chicken. The fried chicken's awesome because it's so tender. It's spicy. It's really yummy.
And of course, I had to get grits too. That's on her plate. Mm-hmm. Since we're down here, I'm gonna probably get grits at every single place we stop.
So we just finished eating at Miller's all day, and after eating both of the fried chicken sandwiches, we wanted to kind of give you a review on what we thought. So we each tasted both, and we both kind of had the same.
I think Tracy's had too much going on. It was, the biscuit was like a donut.
Yeah. It was just a lot of flavor. But the chicken is amazing. Like, their chicken is super moist and fried really well. But then your biscuit.
Yeah, if I had to do it again, I'd probably, like, even though the biscuit was good, I'd probably do away with the biscuit and just have the actual fried chicken.
Their fried chicken is really good. Actually, I think the biscuits are amazing because they are super just
moist
and not dry. Like, sometimes you get biscuits and they're really dry. These were so good. So definitely thumbs up for Miller's all day. All right, we are at the Wreck of the Richard and Charlene, and I read that it's one of the locals' favorites for getting seafood and local food here in the Low Country, but it kind of looks like a wreck. That's where we enter, so we'll go see what it has to offer. And when it happens, all right, so we have our food. This place is pretty cool. It's like totally a dive bar kind of a feel. The staff are super friendly and super welcoming. But anyway, here's what we got. So we got the seafood platter. It has, this is flounder, the fish of the day. There's shrimp on here, scallops, and oysters.
All fried, of course.
Red rice. A hominy square and lima beans.
So,
we are on the Pitt Street Bridge in Charleston, and it's a walking path that is perfect for sunset, and so we are here for sunset. And well, first of all, we have some key lime pie from the Wreck of...
Just the Wreck.
The Wreck.
Yeah.
No, it's a Wreck of Charlene and somebody.
Okay. The Wreck of Charlene.
Here, take a bite. There's a fork. Made in their restaurant, Key Lime Pie. With the sunset in the background.
It's good, of course. Key Lime Pie.
I need a bite. I need a bite. I love Key Lime Pie. Really good. Mmm. Lots of lime in it. Okay, what do we think of the restaurant?
Okay. Fish was okay. Fried, everything's fried, so of course it's gonna be good. Fried oysters tasted really good with the lemon juice, or the, you know, just lemon on it. But then the lady gave us some Tabasco sauce and it was really good.
You don't have to get everything fried. You can have it fried, grilled, or boiled. But we got the fried platter.
You're in the South, get it fried.
Yeah. I'm not a fan of oysters. It was very mushy to me on the inside, so eh. The shrimp was
scallops.
Great.
And I love scallops. We didn't eat anything on it.
I have
good.
To say the scallops were good, because I'm not a scallop fan, but fried was pretty good. And I did taste it with cocktail sauce and with their like tartar sauce, and it's pretty good. But most of all, the service was amazing. Like, super down home, friendly, super helpful. And welcoming, so it's a total dive kind of a place.
Kind of like a beach type dive.
Totally, like, so there were paper tablecloths and paper menus and paper plates.
You know it's good when you just put a piece of paper on as a tablecloth.
Yeah, but it's definitely worth checking out, I would say.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
Enjoy the sunset. All right, we are back at Callie's Hot Little Biscuit because it was so good and we wanted to try some different things. So we'll show you what we're up to and what we're eating. So I got
Bye.
Yeah, that's amazing. The goat cheese is so creamy and good, and these biscuits are just to die for, so it's a great combination.
Now we're going here. to Peace Pie. A friend of mine told me we had to go, so I mean, I can't let her down, so let's go see what we can find in Peace Pie. Dancing on the lawn when it happens, when it happens, when it happens. We'll be dancing. There we go. There it is.
My final decision was salted caramel brownie. That's gonna be good.
It looks really good. They're very frozen.
Okay. You walked out the top, and it's hard.
Because it was in a freezer.
The first bite was good. I do like it like this, getting it right out of the freezer.
Yeah. We have been walking around Charleston today, and so now we are thirsty, and we're going to be heading into Church and Union right behind me. So this bar restaurant is housed in an old church, so let's go check it out inside.
Trace and I have been in Charleston for a few days now, and the only thing we have not tried pretty much for food is oysters, raw oysters. So we're going to go into this restaurant called Amen, and we're going to try some raw, well, I like raw oysters, but I'm going to make her try it too.
And it's happy hour.
We decided to get a dozen, and here's the first one. As usual, not fried, but it's good. Okay, now I'm making Traci do one because she does not want to do it.
I'm putting some lemon juice on here. I mean, look how slimy it is. Ugh. I don't know. Maybe I can just drink it up?
Yep, drink it up. Down the hatch. Not bad. Got done eating our oysters, and they were good.
They were okay.
But we just don't know what the allure of it is. I mean, they're so expensive. Luckily, it was happy hour, but they're so expensive, and they go down in about 2 seconds.
$9 for a dozen, which is
which was good.
Yeah.
Actually, $14 for.
Oh, 14. But you just swallow it, and there's really nothing to it.
That's it. So I started dipping my saltine crackers in the cocktail sauce just to get a little something in my belly. Anyhow, we thought we were done. And then also the lady that was helping us, she said, hey, why don't you go to the rooftop bar? So I guess we're not done yet. We have rooftop bar, and then we will be done.
Then do rooftop bar, voted best rooftop bar in Charleston, 16 years straight.
I am having a local beer. What is it? The Holy City Pilsner. And it's pretty darn good. And Traci's
I'm having
her.
A Moscow Mule, because you can't really go wrong with a mule.
We went to Boxcar Betty's. Everybody told us to go there.
And Cassie.
And we got the signature Boxcar Betty chicken sandwich, which Traci will explain what's on it.
Well, it had, I can't remember.
Of course it's
a
fried.
Slaw, cheese, pimento cheese. Slaw,
and pickles.
Pickles.
And some kind of preserves. And fried chicken.
So good.
Is it so good?
Very tender. It is good. You have to go there then.
We also got fried green tomatoes again because we were told these are the best ones. And I have to say, they're good because they're pickled. So it adds a total different flavor. And then it comes with a spicy mayo. Okay. They're so good because they're pickled. It makes all the difference. So we'll definitely go back and get these Boxcar Betty's.
So it has pimento cheese, peach slaw, pickles, and spicy mayo. Look at those pickles. Those look really fresh.
And it's messy.
Okay, here I go. Messy sandwich. You can tell those are like straight up legit fresh made pickles. It's very good.
All right, Boxcar Betty's. Thumbs up.
Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe to follow our adventures.